Hello and welcome to this SwiftUI tutorial. My name's Cal and in today's tutorial we're going to be building a simple calculator. Calculators are a great beginner programming project as they are small in scope but easy to sort of know what the end result should be. And as I am still very much a beginner when it comes to SwiftUI, I thought I'd have a go at sort of transferring my skills from Storyboard and UIKit and have a go at building a SwiftUI calculator.
Cool, so creating a new Xcode project iOS app. I'm going to call this SwiftUI Calculator. Our interface is SwiftUI and SwiftUI app is our lifecycle. We're just going to hit create and create. We're going to close off a few of these side panes to get a little bit more real estate on the screen. And the first thing we're going to do is we're going to leave that text that's already there, our hello world text, and we're going to nest it in a VStack. Our VStack, we're going to give a background color of black. And our background color, we're going to ignore the safe area. And then for our text, we're going to give it an accent color of white. So changing the text color to white. We're going to put our text inside a HStack. We're going to give it a spacer before the text so that the text aligns to the right. And the font, we're going to give it a little bit bigger. So system size 30, as well as a weight of heavy. And if we hit resume, we can see that actually is a mistake there. We need to add in foreground color. And then we're going to copy and paste that down because we want our workings as well as our results. We're going to make our results a little bit bigger. So the font size to 50. And we're just going to give our HStack a frame. So we're going to say max width equal to infinity as well as a max height equal to infinity. And that just means that it's going to take all of the available space, whether it be vertical or horizontal. And if we hit resume on our preview, we can see that we've got two text views with a back background with a white text aligned to the right, taking up the exact same amount of space in our view. So next what we want to add in is our calculator button, so a grid of buttons. And to achieve this, we're going to create a two-dimensional array. We're going to create an array first, so just having the first row of buttons being this all clear button, backspace, percentage, and divide. And then we're going to create another array. We're going to copy and paste the array of our top row into our grid and then paste that down a few more times, just putting in a comma between each of our arrays. We're going to have five rows, the top row being the one that we already entered. And then we're going to change the next rows to be 789 and a time symbol and just so on and so forth. And now below our HStack, we're going to create a loop. We're going to say for each of our values in our grid, just giving an ID of self row in. So each one of our inner arrays is going to be our row. We're going to say for each of our rows, again giving the ID self, our cell meaning our string. For each of our cells we want to create a button. We're going to create a function below calling it button pressed, which receives a cell, which is a string. Now for our action of our button, we can now call our button pressed and is passing through the cell as our cell. For the label of our button, we're just going to hit enter on that text and just making the text equal to our cell value. And if we hit resume, we can see we've got all of our buttons in a row. That's a little bit hard to read right now, so let's just give our text a foreground color of white. We're going to give our font a little bit bigger, so system 40 and a weight of heavy. We're going to copy and paste down the frame from our text and apply that to our buttons text. And to turn our list of buttons into a grid of buttons, we need to nest our rows inside a HStack. And once we hit resume, we can see that we've got a nice calculator grid. Next, we're going to create another array. We're going to call this operators. And this array, we're going to populate with all of the operator buttons except for the minus sign. So we're going to have divide, plus, times, and percentage. And now we're going to head down and create a function which is going to be button color, which is going to receive a string from our cell and return a color. And we're going to turn our operators orange as well as our clear buttons to red. So we're just going to return white at the bottom. So it's, if it's a number or just by default, we're going to return white. And then we're going to say if the cell is equal to our all clear or our backspace button, we're going to return the color red. And then we're going to, below that, we're going to create another if statement. We're just going to say if our cell is equal to minus or our cell is contained in our operators array that we just created, we're going to return orange, change our foreground color now to be our button color and passing it in the cell. And there's just one that I forgot to do, which is our equal sign. So I'm just going to add that to our orange. So just going to say if cell is equal to an equal sign, then that will also return orange. Cool. So I think that's most of our layout done now. What we're going to do now is create a variable calling visible workings, which is initialized to nothing, as well as a variable calling it visible results. And we're just going to change the text top one being visible workings and the bottom one being visible results. And now inside our button pressed action, we're going to create a switch. It receives our cell value. And we're just going to say if the switch is all clear, we're just going to set visible workings as well as our visible results back to empty. And the default, we're just going to add whatever it is to our visible workings. And I forgot to make these need to be a state variable as they're going to change. So we're just going to change those to be state variables. And then we're going to copy and paste down our all clear case and just put in our backspace button. If our backspace button is pressed, we don't actually need to do anything to our visible results, but we do want to remove the last value from our visible workings. Visible workings drop last and then cast that to a string. We're going to create another case, which is our equal sign, which set our visible results equal to a function, which is going to calculate our results. So we're going to create that now. So we're creating a function function calling it calculate results, which returns a string. We're going to initially just return nothing for now. Then we're going to define a variable calling it workings, which is equal to our visible workings, replacing occurrences of our percentage sign with times 0.1. So whenever you find the percentage sign in our string, we're going to replace it with a times 0.01. And we're going to do the same thing with our capital X and just putting it with a time symbol. And then we're going to say let expression equal to NS expression. Our format, we're going to pass it through our workings and we don't need to give it any arguments. And then we're going to say let result equal to expression, expression value with nil, and the context is nil as well. And then we're going to cast that to a double. And now we've got our result. We want to create another function. We're going to call this format result, which receives a double, so our value, and returns a string. If our val truncating remainder dividing by one is equal to zero, we're going to return the string format of zero decimal places and giving it our value. Otherwise, we're going to return the value to two decimal places. And now we're going to return our format result and just giving it our result. So we could build and run this now and we would have a working calculator. However, the NS expression doesn't really do any error handling. So that's what we're going to do now. We're going to say if valid input and create a function which returns boolean. If valid input, we're going to return our formatted result. Otherwise, we're not going to return anything. We're going to return an empty string. So valid input, the first one we're going to do is if our visible results is empty, return false. And then we're going to say let last equal to a string of our visible workings and get the last character. And then we're going to say if our operators contains our last or our last is equal to a minus sign. If inside that our last is not equal to a percentage sign, then we're going to return false. Otherwise, we're going to return true. Cool. And next, we're going to create another state variable, which is called show alert, which is going to be equal to false. So if there's invalid input, we just want to show our alert. So I'm going to say alert is presented. We're going to give our show alert variable. Inside here, we're going to create an alert. The title is going to be a text of invalid input. The message will be our visible workings, and the dismiss button will be default with a text of OK. And now, inside our calculate results, if invalid input, we're going to show alert is equal to true, and that's going to show our alert. Cool. And we're also going to create a case if it's a negative button. Instead of calculating our results, we're going to say add minus. And inside here, we're just going to do a bit of validation. So we're going to say if visible workings is empty or our visible workings last is not equal to a minus sign already, then in this instance, we're going to add our minus sign to our visible workings. Otherwise, we'll do nothing. And then below that, we're going to create another case, which is going to be for all of our operators. And we're going to create a function calling it add operator. And we're just going to do a little bit more validation here as well. We're going to pass through the cell, so the operator that's been pressed. And we're going to say if visible workings is empty, let last equal to a string value of our visible workings last. And then we're going to say if our operator contains last or last is equal to a minus sign, visible workings remove last. And then we're going to add our visible workings plus equal to our cell value. So we're essentially replacing the last character if it's an operator with the new operator. Cool, so let's build and run this and see if it's working. We're just going to type in 6 plus 6 and it's given us invalid input, which is good because our alert's working. However, this is a bug. We're checking to see if our visible results is empty when we should be checking to see if our visible workings is empty. Cool, so let's test this again. I'm going to test a pretty simple addition and it seems to calculate it there, testing the backspace button as well. And then our all clear button. So yeah, there you have it. There's a pretty simple SwiftUI calculator. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial and I'll catch you guys in the next one.